Okay, action scenes in Hollywood requires professionals to perform stunts because of the danger they pose or because of the insurance liabilities. You don't want to get someone hurt who you're paying the big bucks to, and then you can't even finish the film. So this is when filmmakers call in the stunt doubles to do their dirty work. Sometimes the stunt doubles they call in, they don't resemble the star at all, and sometimes the stunt double can look like the celebrity's practical twin. So this right here is the top 10 best Hollywood stunt doubles. And I'll for sure make another video of the worst, so no worries. So let's start off this list, and at number 10, let's start off this list with Mark Ruffalo and Anthony Molinari. In the film Now You See Me, Mark Ruffalo played the FBI agent. They're on a hunt for a group of criminal magicians. The film was filmed with explosive car chases and dangerous stunts. That's when Anthony Molinari took over. They look so similar that they could have been long lost brothers or something. Moving into number 9 is Kate Winslet and Sarah Fenzel. And we're talking about when they were on the set of Titanic, which came out in 1997. Kate Winslet might have taken all the glory for Titanic, but it was Sarah Fenzel who made it possible. Sarah stood in front of Kate Winslet on many of the most memorable scenes. Sarah said that Titanic was the wettest job that she has ever done, and it was the most physically demanding. Surprisingly, a lot of her shots were filmed of her head on because of the technology to superimpose Kate Winslet's features later. Jean-Claude Van Damme and Todd Senofonte brings us to number 8. Todd has been standing in for Jean-Claude Van Damme for decades now. Their appearances are very similar, and it's actually mind-blowing. He has been compared to Jean-Claude Van Damme on numerous occasions while he was modeling, so he decided to send in pictures to California, and he was called in to come in on set and film with Jean-Claude Van Damme. He has also appeared in 10 movies with him, including Pound of Flesh, Knock Off, and Double Team.
See you next time.
Coming into this list, and at number 7, we have Chris Hemsworth and Bobby Holin Hanton as Thor. Poor Bobby had to consume 35 meals a day and train 18 hours a week in order to match Chris Hemsworth's physique. The bigger he gets, the bigger the stunt double has to get. It just makes sense. Although their faces don't look very similar in action shots, this stuntman did not disappoint. His hair and physique make up for his lack of similar facial features. Bobby said that the training for Thor was the most intense experience he has ever done. And just to make things even more difficult, he had to wear 2-inch platform shoes just so he could measure up to Chris Hemsworth, who's actually 6'3" tall. I guess that's like doing stunts with heels. A little bit harder, a little bit more impressive. Flying their way into number 6, we have Tom Hardy and Jacob Tremblay. These two were seen on set of Mad Max Fury Road. It is rare to see a stunt double and their celebrity look like this much alike. I think that we can all agree that this was a great pairing. There is another picture post on social media of them wearing sunglasses, and it was actually hard to tell who was who. And to think that this pairing almost didn't happen. They were struggling to find a stunt double for Tom Hardy, and one of the colleagues mentioned Jacob, and he was sent on a plane 24 hours later to come on set, but it was match made in heaven. Up next, at number 5, we have Harrison Ford. It's really hard to match him, but we have Vic Armstrong. Vic Armstrong is actually Hollywood's leading stuntman from the 60s to the 90s, and he also worked with Sean Connery and Christopher Reeves. But one of his notable works was when he did a stunt double for Harrison Ford in Indiana Jones. So that's right, Harrison Ford didn't do his stunts in it. It's a very dangerous role. Vic Armstrong actually admitted that Harrison Ford wanted to do almost every single stunt, but he had to talk him out of it because they were very dangerous. He was actually in the Guinness Book of Records as the most prolific stuntman. We're now at number 4. We have Kate Beckinsale and Alicia Villa-Bailey. This picture was taken on set of Total Recall, and it looks like they could have been mistaken for twins. I mean, look at them side by side. It looks like they were separated at birth. For Alicia Villa-Bailey, this wasn't her first stunt job. She worked on many other films such as Avatar, Wonder Woman, Divergent, and many, many more. After her work on Avatar, her career has taken off, and she has been stunt doubles for many A-list actresses such as Mila Jovovich, Charlize Theron, and Jennifer Lawrence. She is a highly sought after stuntman in Hollywood for sure. Number 3 brings us to Arnold Schwarzenegger, and the stunt double for him was actually me. Okay, all jokes aside, because that's never gonna happen, I'm talking about Billy Lucas. This is a picture that was taken on set of Terminator 3 Rise of the Machine with the longtime stunt double Billy Lucas. Billy was also credited with being a stunt double for Arnold Schwarzenegger in his films Kindergarten Cop, Terminator 2, Last Action Hero, and many, many more. Billy Lucas has starred in over 100 films and television productions, and he's also worked as a stunt coordinator. Interesting fact, Arnold Schwarzenegger said that he almost died on set filming True Lies. He was on a horse at the edge of a building when the cameras accidentally touched the horse's nose, which caused him to go crazy. Arnold said he then slipped off the horse right away, and the stuntman grabbed him and pulled him out of danger. He could have fallen 90 feet to a cement floor to his death. And now in at number two, we have Carrie Fisher and Tracy Edin. And we're talking about Star Wars Episode 6, Return of the Jedi, 1983. Interestingly enough, Tracy Edin was also the C-3PO stunt double for Anthony Daniels and Princess Leia. Here is an iconic picture of the two sunbathing in between filming for Return of the Jedi. I guess they needed to have a similar tan. There was actually many versions of this bikini constructed. One was made out of metal for when the actresses was basically stationary, and then there was a bikini made of rubber so then the women can perform stunts comfortably. And finally, we've made it to number one spot for the top 10 best stunt doubles in Hollywood. We have Dwayne Johnson and Tanoay Reed. The man behind the Rock stunts for the past 14 years is this guy. Tanoay Reed is actually his cousin. Dwayne Johnson is one of the highest paid Hollywood action heroes at the moment, but his cousin Tanoay, who performs most of his stunts so that the missions riding on Dwayne Johnson's career isn't put into jeopardy. It also helps that they share genes because the two of them share a very similar body type and stature that is almost impossible to tell that it's The Rock or a stunt double. But the thing is, The Rock just keeps getting bigger and bigger, so I guess they gotta train together. You gotta just keep eating chicken and remember that every day is arm day. But there you guys have it. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys all in the next video. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this video, and let me know if you guys want top 10 worst Hollywood stunt doubles in the comment section below, because I think I'm gonna go create that one. That one just seems really interesting, because sometimes in movies, you can actually tell that it wasn't the person. I'm like, oh my God. And I think one time there was like a black actor or actress, and it was like a white stunt double, and I couldn't figure that one out. Well, thank you guys so much for watching this video. Don't forget to hit that like button if you guys liked it. If you guys didn't, no worries. Hope you'll like the next video. That's it for me, guys. I'll see you in the